In case any of you, and which I can't imagine there are any of you who don't know this, but just in case, this man and this bass guitar are the original pair that played the bass lines that you all know and love on Space Oddity, the whole album, Diamond Dogs, the whole album, that whole tour, the whole works. Here we're in the presence of a legend. I hope you realise this. Welcome, Herbie.
Hurry up. What?
Can I just say, what? Oh, go on, go on. Go, use
yourself. In 1967, I met David in a BBC studio, and Tony Visconti said he's in and out of bands, and he's a bit interesting, and he's got eyeliner on. And he said that he didn't like the version of Space Oddity that they'd done, so he wants a bunch of old jazzers, like himself, like Terry Cox, who was from Pantangle, and a bloke called Rick Wakeman, who had the biggest, longest Cadillac in England. I thought you should know that. And he bought a stylophone for 7 6 with a picture of Rolf Harris on it.
And we have one here tonight.
And we spent, it took a hell of a time, it took all of an hour and 10 minutes to lay this track. And it was the beginning of a lot of prophecies that David made. I'll tell you a bit more later, but don't waste time on me. Here we go, this is Space Oddity, how it was.
And for this, can I just say, especially for this, this doesn't happen often, but
jacket off, or you told me to wear one.
Not just jacket off though, Herbie.
Oh. Woo! Right.
For this one tune. Are you ready for this?
This bass I bought in Manny's in 1959 for $70. It's got the same grits on it and the same everything.
It's the one.
I love it, and it smells a bit.
The bass, the man.
But it's not me.
And the shirt.
Right, that's killed everything stone dead.
Yeah, I do apologise. I just couldn't resist.
The lyrics, we... Bollocks. Here we go. It started, all right?
Control to major tone. You really made the brain. okay. Just...
David wrote and we recorded an album that was going to be called The 1980 Floor Show, but George Orwell's estate wouldn't let David use the term 1984. So David turned it into Diamond Dogs. And we did a 10-month tour of America after recording the album. And it was, I think, the greatest tour anybody could have survived. We did an album called David Live, and I think David even said, this is the life and death of everything. One of the shots on the set of Diamond Dogs were two Twin Towers. And at the end of the concert, all the mongrels, they were the dancers, tore them all down. It's stuck with me forever. It keeps coming back. And one of the great songs, and it's really simple, it should have a cowbell all through it, and this man, I can't believe these wonderful musicians, they live in Brighton, or in the environs, and I love all of you, you're brilliant, and so is Brighton. Rebel, rebel, my age.
Get dancing, everybody. Your face is a mess, Rebel, rebel, how could they know?